Alright, first thing I'm going to do is open Vcarve Pro. Let's look at our material size. I've got this set up to be 30 by 30 inches. I have the thickness set at 3/4 inch, 0.75 inches. So let's move on and to use the ellipse tool. Start making some shapes for an egg tray. 1.5 inches by 1.5 inches. I want to start with the circle because I don't want both ends of the circle tapered out. And if I had to just type the measurements in that I wanted, both ends of my oval would be tapered out, and I don't want that. Now that I'm happy with that, I'm going to select that egg shape, and I'm going to Control C and Control V to make a copy, and I'm going to stretch the copy to about 10 inches by 7 inches, somewhere in there. Like I say, this is just a prototyping. This is going to be my actual shape of my tray. So we'll find out what the final dimensions are when, by the time we get done. I'm going to place these egg shapes all over in not a random pattern, but I don't want it very evenly lined up. So I'm just pressing the control key and clicking and dragging. That will make a copy. And just placing them around the board. We'll move them around the board to fit them better as we work around here. Now that I'm kind of happy with the shape and the layout of the eggs, we're going to save this as an SVG to the desktop, and we'll open that SVG in Lightburn. I'm going to take this file to the laser. I'm going to cut this file out of 1/4 inch plywood, just some scrap stuff, just to see about the placement and how it holds the eggs before I take it out to the router. the 1-inch bowl bit from IDC Woodcraft. Clean up the collet and the collet nut. Drop the collet and the collet nut. Let's just do a test for the spacing. Now I've got them laid out. See what it looks like. One fourth, I think, looks like a good depth. Oh, dang it. Pocket over right. Let's try it on this side. Thank you. We'll rename this layer egg shape, because I'm going to add a new layer for a cutting board. I'll move one of these eggs to the cutting board layer, turn off the egg shape, because I've actually got a test cutting board I did a while back, and I'm going to make this a dual purpose cutting board. One side will be a cutting board, the other side can just be an egg tray. The board is 14 and a half by 11 and a quarter. Give me a rectangle. That rectangle will be 14.5 inches by 13.25 inches. I think that's what I said. No, God almighty. 11 and a quarter. 14 and a half. Measure twice, cut once. So, I'm going to take this egg shape, and I'm going to use the array tool. Let's just see. What was that? Oh, 5 rows, 9 columns, 0.6 by 0.6, X and Y. Hey, that's 25 eggs. Alright, let's see how this works out on an actual cutting board. Reset the view, the preview. Let's calculate the preview. I'm going to go ahead and clamp this wood in. On this older style of clamp, two things I did to improve them. I think I got one of these guys right here. Two things I did. First of all, where the clamp slides to catch your work, I recessed these holes right here. I like having these bolts to have this piece captured so where you they don't come apart. To give it a farther clamping range, I actually recessed the back so the head can go further into the clamp. That means for here on this particular piece, I can't get those holes quite good enough because the piece is just too close. This set of holes is too far away and I can't get a bite. The second thing I did is to recess this side to where this acorn nut sets further back into the clamp, so it closes closer together so you can actually pick this set. You can actually pick that set of holes on your spoil board. As you can see on this clamp, all the way closed, you can't quite get it into that set of pockets. But on this version, that acorn nut goes further in, so it closes all the way against the push. Closes all the way against the block. So when I drop two pins in here, It actually fits in there perfectly. And I can clamp it from this set of holes. And it will even reach from the back set of holes. So with that new design, I can clamp this work at either position. It actually gives me a lower point of contact from the further set of holes. It'll give you more clearance for your tool. I'm just going to leave it sitting in that one for now. There. So you see with this new design, I can go with either set of holes. I made several designs over the past year. This is the first clamp that I designed and 3D printed. As you can see, the block is very large, unnecessarily large. The banana clip actually broke off the end of the connector, so I just unscrewed the jacket and I screwed it directly into the Z-Touch block itself. I took a pair of pliers and I was able to use these threads to thread the aluminum portion. So it doesn't come off anymore, but there you go. And go.
Thank you. That's not good. You can always fill that with epoxy though. I'll show you how I'll fix that in just a minute.
Thank you.
some LED real fast. I don't like this butcher block conditioner I got from Lowe's. It's just mineral oil and beeswax. Make sure you get the whole board coated in the butcher block conditioner. Soak it in mineral oil, soak it in a tub of mineral oil, whatever you want to do. All right. Cutting board, egg tray.